All right, so it's been another couple of weeks. You've probably seen that short I posted of it running, so we know it runs. But I really just have a couple last things to do before I start road testing. Let's take a look at this stuff here. So as you can see, the wheels are off because I am bleeding brakes. So last weekend went to work on the brakes, replaced the two front calipers. Got the beautiful new calipers there, new pads. The rotors are rusty, but they're okay. But went to bleed, and where that orange rag is, that's where the master cylinder is located. Right on the side of the hydro boost. I opened a reservoir and it was filled with a white crusty powder. So that was a bad sign. So I ended up getting a new master cylinder from Rock Auto. All the parts are pretty readily available. And here's the old one. It's kind of crusty looking, but I figured for the $60 for a new master cylinder, it's worth it, because I did clean it out and tried bleeding, and as you can see, there's brown rusty crud coming out of it. So instead of risking it, just got a new one. And then it also turns out that a front brake line on the passenger side was fully blocked. So again, Rock Auto to the rescue with a flexible brake line. I did get the driver's side to bleed, but the passenger side wouldn't bleed, and that's when I had to dive into it further. And found that brake line, flexible brake line, is blocked. So that's on the agenda this weekend, is finishing up the brakes. And then I started getting the radiator in, because I do have some connections, some sensor connections. This is for the fans, and I had to make up a electrical lead for the fans that go to the controller. So that's all done, and those are operating properly. I also went through the fuel system because it wasn't running off the tank, and I discovered that it was sucking air, and there was a air leak somewhere in the fuel system. So I ended up going through the fuel system, and luckily there's access to the top of the fuel tank underneath this bed. Kind of hard to see because the mattress is on, but anyways, got to the fuel tank, took out the float and all that stuff, did some pressure testing on the fuel pickup, and it was fine. Ended up finding a 2-inch piece of flexible hose that was buried in the frame that I could not see, that was dry rotted, and it was leaking air. So right now, the fuel system is 100% operational and perfect from tank to engine. It makes me happy. And I also discovered that the float was corroded and wasn't working either. It wasn't electrically solid, and it wasn't sending the right signal to my gauge package, so that's fixed. Yeah, so it's just a matter of getting the radiator tied in. I got one more upper radiator connection to go to the radiator that's in there. I got all the fittings and stuff for that. And I do want to tidy up the wiring again, but I don't want to do that until this is on the road. And, you know there's no bugs in it, but yeah, it runs. and it sounds so good. Should we try? Let's try. So here's that 1-gauge stuff I'm telling you about. Just a touch screen, pretty cool. I have the tachometer all calibrated through all the stuff up here. Let's see if this baby runs. That battery is weak. Old school right there. That battery might be too weak. Now I only do have it hooked up on one battery here, but that battery's been sitting around for 2 years without any use, so I might need a new battery. And I do plan on getting, I don't know, dual batteries for it, but all in due time. My main goal is to get this on the road, hopefully this weekend. So the next video you see, I should be driving it. Fingers crossed. Hopefully there's no roadblocks. But stay tuned, and the next video will be of this baby driving down the road, hopefully. While it's in the air, I did put it in gear and drive and reverse, and the wheels spun. That doesn't mean that the transmission is 100%. We're gonna find out. I got a good feeling though, so fingers crossed on that. But yeah, stay tuned, more to come. We'll see you on the road.